Hi everyone, this is Anomalous here again, and we're going to do another ACR case in point. So here we have a 79-year-old man with a history of melanoma who presents for a PET CT, which the following incidental findings is demonstrated in the axial PET CT fusion image. Hypermetabolism in the right cerebellum, hypermetabolism in the left cerebellum, hyperperfusion of the right cerebellum, or normal exam. I think it's hypermetabolism. Right. Ooh, burned. On normal exams, physiologic FDG accumulates is most intense in the cerebral cortex, basal ganglia, thalamus, and cerebellum, since the brain is dependent on glucose metabolism exclusively. The right half of the cerebellum demonstrates normal FDG accumulation, which is incomparable to intensity in the normal left temporal lobe. In that case, the left hemisphere of the cerebellum demonstrates decreased FDG accumulation. 9 months prior to the index PET CT fusion exam, the patient had a chief complaint of left hemiparesis. Which of the abnormalities on the contrast-enhanced axial CT angiographic image and/or axial T2-weighted MRI, both from 9 months earlier, could help explain the patient's complaint at this time? Right internal carotid artery, which looks a little odd here, different flow void here. Left ICA, basilar artery, right internal jugular. Here we have vertebrals. You can see the vertebrals on this CT here. Let's go with the right ICA. The expected flow relayed signal within the right ICA is not seen on MRI. It should have been black. Near complete occlusion of the origin of the right ICA on the CT. 4 days later, after CTA and MRI, the patient had a follow-up non-contrast head CT. Two representative axial images are shown below. So here it looks like this kind of ill-defined hypodensity, not going completely to the cortical gray matter, mainly affecting the white matter, with some effacement in the ventricles, no midline shift. So, it looks like a sizable infarction in the right MCA territory, a large infarction in the left cerebellar hemisphere, infarction involving the right posterior cerebral artery, PCA territory. It looks like that is definitely true. That is possible. Yep. So, given the additional imaging findings, which is the most likely explanation for the current PET CT findings? So, we have right ICA abnormality causing this left cerebellar hypoperfusion. I think it might be this crossed cerebellar diaschisis. Considering the findings of a large right hemispheric cerebral infarction, the most likely diagnosis is CCD. CCD, or crossed cerebellar diaschisis, is a functional match to metabolic depression of decreased blood flow and oxygen extraction in the cerebellar hemisphere contralateral to a lesion in the supratentorium, which is most commonly due to a large middle artery territory infarction. Now, although large MCA territory infarctions are the most common cause of CCD, other possible etiologies for corticopontocerebellar tract disruption include which of the following? Certainly that's a possibility. Focal trauma? Not necessarily. It's possible. Epilepsy, I understand, usually affects hippocampus. I'm going to go with these. Ooh, that should have been checked in. That should not have. CCD is more severe with frontal lobe tumors, high-grade malignant tumors, and large tumors versus smaller benign tumors. CCD is seen more often in patients with focal cortical or extraparenchymal injuries, and is unlikely in patients with multiple or diffuse brain injuries. So figure one, the expected flow relayed signal in this, the right IC is not seen on T2 weighted MRI. So that should have been, it's tough to see now that circle, but it should have been black like the other side. Basilar artery blood flow is identified, purple. Again, black. Image 2 shows near complete occlusion of the origin of the right ICA on CT angiogram, red arrow. The left ICA is patent, the yellow circle. The right internal jugular is patent, blue circle. A recent right MCA ischemic vent was confirmed on this axial diffusion weighted and ADC map, which is not shown in MR images. So, crossed cerebellar diaschisis. CCD is defined as a functional match of metabolic depression or decreased blood flow and oxygen extraction in the cerebellar hemisphere contralateral to a focal supratentorial lesion. The underlying mechanism of CCD is disruption of the supratentorial portion of the corticopontocerebellar tract secondary to damaged excitatory corticopontine projections, which is most commonly seen with large MCA territory infarctions. Although most commonly seen with infarctions, CCD is seen with other etiologies such as brain tumors, spinal cerebellar degeneration, Alzheimer's disease, and epilepsy. PET CT fusion axial sections in the index case show FDG hypometabolism in the right frontal parietal region as a result of MCA and PCA territory infarctions that occurred 9 months prior. The contralateral cerebellum also shows FDG hypometabolism without concurrent cerebellar morphological changes such as atrophy or encephalomalacia. CCD is defined as a functional match metabolic depression or decreased blood flow and oxygen extraction in the cerebellar hemisphere contralateral to a focal supratentorial lesion. The underlying mechanism of CCD is disruption of the supratentorial portion of the corticopontocerebellar tract secondary to damaged excitatory corticopontine projections. In this case, due to a sizable right MCA infarction, decreased excitatory output causes functional deafferentation and decreased physiological activity. Although most commonly seen with infarction, CCD is encountered with other etiologies such as brain tumors, spinal cerebellar degeneration, Alzheimer's disease, and epilepsy. Studies have shown the cerebellum can recover from early functional hypoperfusion, thus making it reversible in many cases and without clinical consequence. The mechanisms by which cerebellar metabolism returns to normal are not clearly understood. In other cases, usually with progressive or insidious injuries such as brain tumors, it may eventually cause anterograde transneural degeneration in the connecting brain regions, usually the contralateral cerebellar hemisphere, and become irreversible. Functional CCD findings may persist on PET or SPECT scans up to 20 years after infarction, indicating irreversibility of the lesion even if it remains clinically occult. Most CCD studies have not shown anatomic changes such as cerebellar atrophy, particularly when caused by ischemia. However, crossed cerebellar atrophy on MRI has been noted in patients with long-standing intractable seizures and large areas of cerebral atrophy. Although CCD has been studied in stroke patients with both PET, single photon emission computed tomography, or SPECT, and MRI perfusion, its prognostic value is still unclear. Although it should not be used as independent outcome predictor, recent studies have shown that the size of CCD after middle cerebral territory infarction correlates with acute and chronic hypoperfusion volume from infarction, neurological severity of the patient, and the degree of disability. CCD is typically more severe with larger supratentorial infarctions, malignant versus benign, and larger neoplasms, particularly in the frontal lobes. There you have it, guys, today's review of the ACR case in point. Thanks very much to ACR for putting this together. They send one out to my email every single day, so check them out. Thanks too, as well, to Mizzou, University of Missouri. And in the background, you have Lindsay Sterling. I'm Anomalous. Thanks for checking me out. Thanks for checking out my YouTube channel. Also, check out my Twitter. Follow me there, as well as follow me on my Twitch TV, where you'll see radiology as well as a lot of gaming. Right now, Diablo 3. Thanks very much, guys. Take care. We'll see you next time.